Just a quick vlog today. I kind of think my painting video was a vlog for yesterday. Probably cheating, but I was kind of busy yesterday. I cooked a pot roast for my son and I, and he came over, and we watched Sherlock Holmes, and I had a good time. I was going through, I've been watching some videos on Vloggerheads, trying to get to know some of the people over there. I've been posting my videos primarily in both places, YouTube and Vloggerheads. It's kind of fascinating. The any videos dealing with religion get a much greater reception on YouTube than they do on Vloggerheads. Vloggerheads seems to be an enclave of folks that I can't say they're all atheists, because I mean I know Pastor Donovan's over there, and there's other people over there that have religious beliefs, but and it's harsh to say it's a hostile environment to religion, because I don't think that's true either, but it's just not as receptive when it comes to religious videos or concepts or discussions. You know what I mean? Not that that's a bad thing. It's just a kind of a difference of feel. You know, when you enter the two communities, it's I think perhaps it's the circle of people that watch my videos on YouTube and that I interact with. Whereas on Vloggerheads, it's pretty much, because it's such a small site, there's, you know, people watch other people's videos just because they're up there at times. You know, and I've talked about the fact before that I think it's good for us to be exposed to different ways of thinking, even if we aren't comfortable with them. Because if we surround ourselves with people that primarily agree or validate our perceptions of the world, then we might be missing something pretty important, you know? I always think it's a good idea to just, you know, talk to just about anybody. I mean, I have my limits on folks I'll talk to. So it got me thinking about videos, and I went and looked at my my list of videos on YouTube, and I looked at the I sorted them by most viewed. Let's see what comes up for most subscribed. I mean, most discussed. Yeah, it's virtually the same. The most viewed and most discussed videos on my channel on YouTube are controversial in some nature, drama, if you will, or, you know, people aren't all that interested in just everyday kind of vlogs. They're more interested in anything that has to do with drama. The only exception would be, and this is kind of a weird anomaly, I'm not sure why this video has this many views, but I did a video about a teacher being fired for kids having sex in her classroom. A couple of kids distracted her, and one kid gave another a blowjob underneath the science table or something. That video has 55,000 views. I don't know. I don't know why, unless it's something in the search tags or something that caused it to have that many views. But it's generally drama stuff, or, you know, stuff like that. And just the everyday kind of stuff, or the vlogging stuff, or even some of the creative stuff, doesn't have nearly the views that the drama stuff does. So, as much as people say they don't want drama, I think there's some, I think some people have an inability to ignore it. To you know, they gotta look. You know, it's like when you're a kid and they and then have the fair come around, and you know, they always had the tent with the half naked girls in it, and you know, all the adults men would go in there, and you know, us boys weren't allowed in there. We were always trying to peek. I don't know. I'm sure there's some psychology in there somewhere. So I've had I've had some really nice responses on both sites for my painting. Some people were very honest and not criticizing, but providing suggestions and you know, noting the fact that one side of the picture was definitely much better executed than the other side. I had a vision for the right hand side, but man, it didn't turn out that way. Somebody said I could go back and paint over it with oil paint. I don't know how long you have to let it dry before you can start messing with it again, because it, I mean, today I noticed it's still like almost like I painted it yesterday, you know. It hasn't dried at all, in other words. So I think it takes a long time for oil paint to dry. But it was a good learning experience. And then I got some really good advice from Tree, who always gives pretty good advice, you know, in terms of just, you know, paint 500 pictures and then we'll talk about technique. I like that. I like that thinking. And I do think that while the formulaic painting is okay for you to start to learn some techniques and how to do things, at some point in time, it really has to be about your own personal expression. And that personal expression has to be, whether anybody else likes it or not, you know what I mean? It's your art. You know, it's like people who do videos in an artistic fashion, whether it's YouTube or Vloggerheads, it's a form of art. And often they do it not because, you know, they want somebody else to tell them how great it is. It's because it's their art and that's what they do. So I think that's kind of cool. Although, you know, I have to say, I'm sure that, I mean, there has to be an element of artistic expression that includes the concept of positive feedback or reinforcement or encouragement or, you know, some kind of a self-esteem builder of sorts, where somebody says, wow, that's really good. I mean, that has to register on some level. I don't care how aloof you think you are. I mean, that still must have to hit a button, you know, somewhere to say, wow, that's cool, somebody really liked it. can't think of anything else that's going on. I was looking out my window, because it's a pretty dark, dreary day out there, pretty yucky. Plus, I was thinking, I haven't had anything to eat since breakfast, and it's 6 o'clock, and I'm kind of hungry. I was wondering if I was going to do anything about that or not. I was trying to get back into an exercise routine of some kind. I need to do the swimming. That's really the best exercise for me in my current situation. But because I got away from any kind of weight training or anything, especially after I hurt my shoulder a couple of years ago, and I did it doing the way, you know, I joined a gym and decided I was, you know, I'm watching all these guys with, you know, the huge muscles, and they're doing these kind of exercises. I'm like, that's what I got to do. I blew my shoulder out. But I was trying to do just, you know, like girly push-ups the other day, and I realized this shoulder won't take any weight. I can't put any weight on it. So I think I'm going to have to try and come up with some kind of an intermediate process to build up the muscles enough so that they're able to protect whatever's going on with that shoulder. And if that doesn't work, I guess I got to go back and see, you know, somebody in orthopedics about, do we need to do something again with this shoulder? Which, you know, I just got through this whole pain and all that kind of stuff. I'm really not looking forward to putting myself into any kind of position. That doesn't hurt when I'm swimming. So, I mean, really, that's, you know, it's like you go to the doctor and, you know, my eye hurts. Every time I drink my cup of coffee, take your spoon out of your coffee. You know, maybe I just don't mess around with the shoulder in that way. I just do the swimming. Better aerobic exercise, anyway. It's probably better for losing weight. although, you know, I kind of wanted to do some muscle stuff because I think it's good for your metabolism, you know, if you're doing some kind of muscle training. I'm pretty sure it's good for your metabolism. So today has been a good day. Not too many complaints. I created a profile on one of those online dating sites. It's really scary. It's really scary for a guy, you know, an old fart like me, who hasn't even thought about dating for a long, long time. You know, and since recently my wife and I have, you know, decided that we're going to call it quits, it's been kind of scary. You know, I'm not even sure how that works anymore, and I'm certainly not sure what expectations are or any of that kind of stuff when you're doing that stuff. So it's, I don't know. It's going to be interesting to see how this all turns out. But you know, I was trying to fill out one of those profile things where you talk about, you know, who you are and what you like and all that stuff. You know, I must have gone back and edited the thing like 100 times because I couldn't figure out what I wanted to say and how I wanted to say it. Very strange. That's going to be an interesting experience, I'm sure. Not too much else going on that I can think of at the moment. I think that's probably it for today's vlog. And I'll see if I can do another 20 minute or something later. Talk to you guys soon.